Hello, fellow educators, and welcome to the Making HEADway Classroom series. My name is 𝗙𝗥𝗘𝗘, and as a dedicated mathematics teacher with 16 years of experience at the Philippine Science High School, I'm here to share a slice of my classroom with you. This video series is an integral component of the HEAD Foundation's Making HEADway ecosystem, a comprehensive open access collection designed to enhance the professional development of teachers across Southeast Asia. Delve into our rich archive of past webinars by clicking the link provided in the description below. You'll also discover my personal contributions on weaving the arts into STEM education, featured in the fifth handbook of our extensive online resource library. Imagine wielding a simple sheet of paper, not just as a surface for notes, but as a dynamic, powerful tool for unlocking mathematical concepts. This is the magic of origami, the traditional Japanese art of paper folding, and our focus today. Origami traces its roots back to ancient Japan, where skilled artisans folded paper into intricate shapes, animals, and even mythical creatures. It comes as no surprise that their art form would one day intersect with mathematics. So join me as we explore how this elegant art form can become one of your keys in engaging and teaching students. In Southeast Asian schools, these topics are typically introduced during junior high school. However, don't underestimate the power of origami even for senior high school students. Whether you're teaching in the Philippines, Indonesia, or Thailand, origami transcends borders and engages learners of all ages. Origami isn't just about math. It's about creativity, spatial reasoning, and patience. As teachers, we can inspire our students to fold their way to deeper understanding. To conduct this lesson in your classroom, you will need sheets of origami paper, enough for all students, a protractor or a triangle to verify our measurements, a pair of scissors, some tape, a pencil or a pen, and a board to show and explain solutions. Our objectives for today's activities are for our students to identify and describe specific mathematical properties emerging from paper folding, construct mathematical proofs to explain why the observed properties hold true in the context of paper folding, and establish connections between the mathematical concepts encountered during paper folding and their existing mathematical understanding. For this origami activity to really unfold its potential, it's crucial that our students come equipped with an understanding of triangle similarity, the properties of 30, 60, 90 triangles, the Pythagorean theorem, and the basics of line and angle bisection. As we dive in, they'll be engaging directly with these concepts through hands-on paper folding. This tactile approach not only encourages discovery, but also sparks lively discussions that enhance critical thinking. Teachers, let us start folding. Everyone, take a piece of square paper. In origami, we have two fundamental types of folds: mountain folds and valley folds. This fold here is a mountain fold because it rises like a mountain. And this one is called a valley fold. Imagine a valley sinking down. Every edge and fold is a line on our paper, and their intersections form angles. Now, observe the corners of our origami paper. What do we see? Yes, they're perfect right angles, a crisp 90 degrees, or pi over 2 radians. Let us try something. We will take this edge and fold it right over to meet its partner, bisecting our line segment with precision. And just like that, our fold becomes a perpendicular bisector. Neat, isn't it? But why stop there? Pick any angle. Go ahead. Any corner will do. We're going to fold the paper so the sides line up with each other. Slicing that angle right down the middle. We've just bisected an angle. Let us start by constructing a 30-60-90 triangle. Instead of relying on a protractor for angle measurements, we will use paper folding to precisely create this triangle. Once you've folded your triangle, we'll dig into the reasoning behind its properties. Grab yourself a square or rectangular piece of paper to start. Now we're going to bisect one side. Simply fold it in half. This fold that you've made down the middle, this is what we call the midline. Now let's fold the upper right corner of the paper so that it gently touches the midline and make sure that the fold runs straight through the upper left corner, like so. And there you have it. With just two folds, you've created a 30-60-90 triangle. But let's not just take our word for it. If you grab a protractor, you can measure the two angles to check our work. I can see you're wondering, how did that just happen? Well, let's dive into the proof. On our diagram here, you will notice that AB is equal to AB prime. They mirror the same edge before and after the fold you made. Through folding, AM has become half the length of AB. Follow along with me. This also means that AM is half the length of AB prime. Got that? Good. Since angle AMB prime forms a nice right angle and AM is half the hypotenuse of our new triangle AMB prime, this makes it a classic 30, 60, and 90 triangle. This means angle B prime, AB, is exactly 60 degrees. Keep in mind, this triangle we're talking about is just in the illustration, not on your paper. Now for the grand finale. Line AC here bisects angle BAB prime, slicing it into 30 degrees. Double check this by folding along line AB prime. The left edge should align with line AC, proving we've perfectly trisected the 90 degree angle. Everyone, you may use the same paper. Your challenge now is to construct an equilateral triangle without using measuring instruments. Each angle measures exactly 60 degrees. I'll show you how to do this after 10 seconds. You may want to pause this video now and do it on your own first. Here's my equilateral triangle. Does it look the same as the one you made? What additional steps did you do to construct your triangle? Let us expand to the third dimension with this activity. A tetrahedron is one of the five platonic solids, with four equilateral triangles for its faces. A four-sided die is in the shape of a tetrahedron. For this activity, we'll need more paper, a pair of scissors, and some adhesive tape. First, fold your paper in half across the middle. Bring the left side over to meet the right. Just like that. Now, with our midline fold hugging the left side, we're going to fold down the top half to strike up another midline crease. On this top layer, we're going to craft another 30-60-90 triangle. Then fold it along the shorter edge to form an equilateral triangle. Here we go. Next, take your scissors and we're going to make a cut, a horizontal one, straight through the bottom corner of our equilateral triangle. Now for the magic part. Slap some adhesive tape on the top and bottom edges of our paper. Go ahead, tape it up nice and neat. And then, let's unfold our creation to reveal the tetrahedron. Take a look at this. By the way, this tetrahedron here, it's part of a special family called the platonic solids, where each face is a regular polygon. There are only 5 members in this exclusive club. The tetrahedron itself, a cube or hexahedron with square faces, the octahedron with triangular faces, like our friend here, the dodecahedron with pentagonal panels, and lastly, the 20-faced icosahedron. Now picture this. Ancient Greek mathematicians with compass and straight edge in hand, constructing a world of mathematical objects, all neatly bound by a set number of steps. They encountered 3 notorious problems: squaring the circle, trisecting an angle, and doubling the cube. But here's where we take a sharp turn into the modern lane with mathematical origami. You see, it hands us the key to one of these ancient puzzles, trisecting an angle, with nothing more than a plain rectangular piece of paper. Let me walk you through it. Take this paper and make an arbitrary fold right from the lower left corner to the top. This here, this angle, is our candidate for trisection. Now, bend the base of our paper up to form a rectangle, like so. And then, double down on it. Fold again to overlay a twin rectangle right on top. Next, we're going to get crafty with our folds. Swing that lower left corner so it reaches up, touching our first horizontal line. While this endpoint here plays tag with the angle we started with. To wrap this up, we're just going to follow the trail of the initial horizontal fold. Extend the crease. And reveal the corner. Now take a peek as we dissect the larger angle from our last step. And ta-da! We have 3 congruent angles proving our trisection. But we can't just leave it at that, can we? A good mathematician doesn't rest until the whys are laid out clear as day. So let's roll our sleeves up and show why the trick works every single time. Label A, B, and M. By our construction, M is the midpoint of segment AB. By our folding, A prime, B prime, and M prime correspond to A, M, and B. And M prime is also the midpoint of segment A prime, B prime. This implies B prime, M prime is equal to M prime, A prime. Side A, M prime is equal to itself by the reflexive property. Angle B prime, M prime, and A is equal to angle A prime, M prime, and A, and are both right angles by our construction. Therefore, triangle A, M prime, B prime is congruent to triangle A, M prime, A prime. by side angle side correspondence. And angle alpha is equal to angle beta, since corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Let us draw. Segment A prime C, perpendicular to the base of our paper. This means angle A prime C, A, is 90 degrees. Now, A prime M prime is equal to A prime C, which is equal to AM. Side A, A prime is equal to itself by the reflexive property, and the right triangle A, M prime, A prime is congruent to right triangle A, C, A prime, since their hypotenuses and corresponding legs are equal. Finally, angle beta is equal to angle gamma, since corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. So angle alpha is equal to angle beta is equal to angle gamma, trisecting our original angle. In this quick video, we've merged the elegance of art with the clarity of mathematics. Starting with just a square paper, we meticulously folded our way to a 30-60-90 triangle, each angle sharp, each side in proportion. And we did it all without a protractor in sight. But we didn't just stop with a triangle. We used it as a springboard to form an equilateral triangle, and from there, leaped into the world of three-dimensional shapes. We even tackled the classic challenge of trisecting an angle, something that stumped scholars for centuries if they only had a compass and straight edge. But with origami, we found a way. However, remember that at the core of every fold we made is solid mathematical proof. We've taken care to illustrate the whys as clearly as the hows. So, my fellow educators, I encourage you to bring these exploratory activities into your classrooms. Link these origami folds to mathematical principles and watch as a spark of curiosity lights up in your students. And a small reminder as you embark on this journey of discovery with your students. Precision matters. Neat folds lead to precise measurements, while clean hands help create beautiful and accurate models. Throughout this lesson, I have always kept in mind my mentor, Dr. Rene Felix, who has always taught mathematics with wonder and joy. He passed away a few years ago, and I share these classroom lessons with you in his memory. While our knowledge in mathematics may be finite, through every lesson we impart and every mind we ignite, we hold the power to unfold a world of infinite possibilities. Thank you for joining me on this journey of folds and figures. For more insights and innovative teaching methods, visit the links in the description. See you soon!